Hi everyone, this is Ruthraj and welcome to our channel Join. Today we'll be discussing on two very important key points, that is RSI and stochastic RSI. These two are very frequently used, so I would highly recommend that you watch through the video with great attention. So first we'll discuss RSI. The full form of RSI is relative strength index. So let me give you an example. So relative strength example, first of all let's see the formula. So the formula is simple, that is average gain divided by average gain plus average loss. Let's see how you can actually compute it. So say for example you have these four candles. Say for example here it started at 100, then it went up to 110, then it went up to 130, and then it fell to 125, and finally it halted at 120. So let's see how you can compute the RSI over here. If you see, so the first price was 100, then it moved to 110, then from 110 it moved to 130. And then from 130 it fell down to 125, and then from 125 it again fell down to 120. So if you see here it made a gain of 10, here it made a gain of 20, then here it made a loss of 5, and here also again a loss of 5 points. So if you see the average gain here, in this case average gain would be 10 plus 20 divided by 2, that is 15, right? So how much total gain it has made divided by the number of times the gain has been made, that is 1, 2. Similarly, now let's see the average loss. So average loss would be total loss, that is 5 plus 5 by number of times the loss was made, 2 times. So this is equivalent to 5. Now if we substitute the value in our RSI formula, so RSI would be average gain, that is 15, divided by average gain plus average loss, that is 15 divided by 20. This is nothing but is equal to 3/4. Is equivalent to 0.75. So you can see that the RSI value comes out to be 0.75. So in our case the RSI generally lies between 0 and 100. So in a general notion, if the RSI value crosses 70, say for example the RSI is something like this. Say for example in our case it was 0.75, you can multiply 100 to make it into percentage, like 75%. So example here our value is at around this one, 75. So it has already crossed the 70 mark, right? So if the RSI crosses this 70 mark, generally it is said that this is in overbought zone. So what you can do here, you should sell your assets, or you can take a short position, or you can just sell the assets that you have. So RSI above 70 denotes that it is in overbought zone and it might fall down, the price might fall down now. So this is what RSI above 70 indicates. Now let's see if RSI falls below 30 level, then this indicates weakness. So that means it is in super weak zone. Now the price may reverse. So RSI below 30 indicates it is in oversold zone. So price might go upwards, and here RSI above 70 is overbought zone. So price might fall down from here. So you should be aware of it. So now, similar to RSI, we also have a stochastic RSI. The formulae to calculate the stochastic RSI is this one. So here I forgot to mention one thing, that RSI is computed generally over 14 period. You can use other periods, but 14 period is pretty good. You can try it out. Now let's see what exactly is stochastic RSI. So stochastic RSI is computed by, first you compute the RSI just like we computed here, then you compute the mean of the last 14 RSI. So there would be candles, right? So you are computing RSI at each level. So say for example there are lot of candles here. So here there would be one RSI value, here there would be another RSI value, and so on, right? So you take the mean of last 14 RSI, you take the max of last 14 RSI, and you also take the mean of here last 14 RSI. So what you do is RSI minus mean of last 14 RSI whole divided by max of last 14 RSI minus mean of last 14 RSI. So you would get a stochastic RSI value. Now how can you actually use it? The stochastic RSI value generally lies between 0 and 1. So similar to RSI, you can use it that if it is say below 0.2 generally, then it indicates, this zone indicates oversold zone, and the price might reverse and price might go upwards, and this zone indicates overbought zone, and the price might fall down from here. So this stochastic RSI is also used as an oscillator. What does oscillator means? Oscillator is generally used by traders to use it as a trading perspective. So you want to exit as soon as possible, right? So in this case you can use any oscillator. There are a lot of oscillators, but stochastic RSI is one of the very good oscillators. So you can use it as a trading tool. So above 0.8, it is in overbought zone, so you can take a short position or you can sell, and below 0.2, it is in oversold zone, so you can think of buying here. So I think we have covered what we have intended to cover in this lecture. So thank you for watching, and we'll be with a next video with a new concept. So till then, take care. Thank you. Bye bye.